Citadel Shades are very thin panes that are designed to run into the details of your miniatures and accentuate them, and I believe that they are invaluable to every painter. I'm going to show you now how great they look when you paint them onto a miniature and how they really bring them to life. So as always, give the paint a good shake before you use it. And here it is, I've got Caraberg Crimson. And what I like to do is load up the brush with a nice dollop of the paint and just create a little puddle like this on a palette, because this means I can control how much paint I've got on the brush. Now the brush I'm using is a wash brush, which is designed for doing this kind of thing, but if you're painting a smaller area, like say a sword hilt, then it's best to pick a smaller brush, something like a detail or something like that. But for this miniature, this bloodletter, because I'm going to be painting this shade all over him, then I want quite a brush that's going to hold quite a lot like this. So here we go. Just paint it on, and immediately you can see it all starting to run into all the details of the miniature. Now it's looking great already, isn't it? So, thing to watch out for with this is be generous when applying it, but don't go crazy. Don't say apply that much like we got on his hand there, because when that dries, that'll look, well, all lumpy and horrible, and it'll start to clog up that detail. So just keep the paint moving and keep moving it all around the model. Now, because this is such a thin paint, it will take quite a while to dry, so I'm going to leave this for about half an hour. That should be okay. It's very important that you do that, because, well, when you go on to the next colour, you don't want it to start running into this one. Right, there we go. The shades are now dry, and I've added another colour to his tongue and another to his sword. But you can see immediately the detail and definition that they brought out on the miniature. So, to recap, when you're using these paints, be sure to give them a good shake before you start to use them. Be generous with how much you apply, but don't go crazy, and whilst it's drying, just keep an eye out for any drips and blobs that start to appear on it. But that's how easy it is to add this definition to your miniatures, so go and get some shade and try it out.